Hello, good evening and good afternoon everyone joined from the different location of the world. So today webinar is about building an API platform for digital transformation. So I am Sanjeev Mahagoda and I am working as associate technical lead of WSO2 API management team. And also I have Danuka Ranasinghe with me. He is also working as associate technical lead at API management team. So we both today we will discuss about building an API platform for the digital transformation. So this is our topic outline for today. First, we will briefly discuss about APIs. Then we will quickly discuss about building your business with APIs. And also under that, we will discuss about the expanding business by exposing your services solutions as API. Then also we will discuss about integrate your business with the different external services using APIs. And also then we will discuss about the integrate with the different standard protocols. And then we will discuss about the improve business intelligence by stats and analysis of the API stats. Then we will do a quick demo to demonstrate how you can use API management solution to integrate your services with different protocols and different message types. So during the demo, we will see how we can do that with the API manager. So let's first talk about the APIs. So nowadays, APIs are like those are using everywhere. So this API word is you can hear it everywhere. So these are some of the examples to check whether you have used APIs or not. So each and every time we are using Google or Facebook, we are accessing APIs. And also when we try to buy something from the Amazon or eBay, and when we try to use the credit card or those kind of electronic transactions, then again we are using APIs. So each and every person in this world nowadays using APIs. So the advantage of having API-enabled business is that so each and every business and solutions, all these are connected through the APIs. So next, we'll check why we need APIs. So mainly, APIs needed to integrate different platforms and clients. So like Android, iOS, Windows Phone, or it can be smart TV. All these devices need to be connected and they need to consume data. So as example, we can consider about ticket selling API or ticket buying API. So when you have mobile device and when you are trying to buy a ticket or something, then again it will call to ticket search API, which is deployed in some of the application server. Then you will get customized response according to your preference and other your attributes. So from that you can buy tickets and you can rate them and you can view upcoming events. So all these things can be done using APIs. And also APIs will offer key to providing the agility and accelerate the innovations. So if we consider the if you consider today industry, so innovations play a very critical part. So each and every service will develop day by day. So they will add different components, different features, and many different functionalities day by day. So when we have this kind of very agile development process, it is very important to update these services very frequently. So if you are using APIs, then you can easily do this thing because we have API versioning concept. So let's say you have developed the service and you have version 1 and later you have added some improvement, then you can version that as version 2 and you can release client based on the version 2. So if you can have proper versioning strategy, then we can develop the clients based on that. And also we can use it across different platforms and different products. without much complexity. So that's another advantage of having APIs. And also APIs enable the content distribution and enable transaction from the wide variety of sources. And also having APIs in some organization will accelerate client partner onboarding. So let's say when we have some business, then there will be new client who want to work with us. And if we have proper APIs defined for the functionalities offered by our organization, then they can easily develop their clients and or mock services, and they can very easily integrate their systems with our one if we have a proper API. So as example, if we consider about some platform like PayPal or other common payment gateways, so they have proper APIs. So anyone in world can easily integrate with their systems because they have well-defined APIs. So when we start this kind of thing, we don't need to go and talk to them each and every time. We can simply take the API documents and get their service endpoint. And also with the proper APIs, they have some mock APIs. So with that, we can start the development and we can test them. And eventually, we can go for the production with their real APIs. And also, stats and analytics will help you to analyze the trends and patterns. So when you have some kind of API, then you can check time-to-time what kind of people are using these APIs and what is the geographical locations these users are coming from. And those kind of different information you can get from the API stats. So with that, you can redesign your business, and also you can expand your business. So as example, let's say you are doing some pizza selling application, and if you have stats for that particular application, then after some time you can get some idea about which part of the country order pizza very frequently. And also based on that stats, you can start new shop or new outlet in that area. So likewise, you can develop and implement your services based on the stats. So those are the main advantages of having APIs for the business. Next, we will see how we can build business with the APIs. So these days, growing number of consumers and business incorporate web and mobile applications into their daily routines and businesses. So as example, let's say when we start our day, we start with tea or coffee. So we can order it online and go to shop and pick it. Then again, we will catch the train or we can get the bus. So again, we will take mobile device and check application to check the availability of the buses or trains. So likewise, when we go back home, we will check movies or any other entertaining programs. Then again, we will use these APIs. So likewise, these APIs are now affecting our day-to-day business and also our day-to-day life. And also APIs are tools that allow business to put data to use. So you may have data in your organizations, but to make them useful or to get the real use of that, we need to expose them properly. So to expose them, we need APIs as a tools. And also APIs are inspiring innovative developers to create new business opportunities and improve the existing products or system and operations. So having proper APIs will always help to developers, because by mentioning proper API, so when you have proper API, we need to have proper API, API document, API definition, and testing endpoint. So all those things should be there. So when we have all these things, users can easily start learning about APIs, and they can easily use them. So to discuss this further, we will take one small example. So let's say we have a old-fashioned sandwich factory where customers visit the store, and they will call us, and they will place the order. So basically they say, this is the sandwich I need, so this kind of bread I need, this kind of meat I need. So likewise they will give a certain requirement, and based on that we will place the order. Then after we completed the sandwich, we will talk to client again, and they will pay for that. Then they can take it out or they can have it inside, or else we will deliver it to client home, and they can pay money at their home. So this is the traditional sandwich business. So with this kind of traditional business, we don't have any APIs or any electronic transactions or any of these kind of things. So now let's see how we can engage APIs for this business. So if we think of online ordering process, then we can introduce something like that for this particular business. So then we can make order API. Then users can place their orders by logging to online system through the API. And also mobile and web application developers can use this API to order sandwich from their applications. And also we can provide the option to customize the sandwich according to users' preferences. So if you have this kind of API, then when someone develop applications, like when you go to famous cities of the world, then they will have different applications. So inside those applications, they have certain ways to order the food and drinks, which is from the shops near you. So for this kind of applications, they need the APIs. So if you have this kind of API, then those application developers can use this API, and they can effectively make orders and use our system. Next, we can use this API to get the feedback and responses through the same API, and also we can let users to edit and update the orders from this system. So all these things can expose as APIs. So when someone write client, they can easily use them. Then next part of this is having API stats. So API stats will be collected when request invocation happens. So if you know about WS2 API manager stats, so basically we have a usage stats handler. So it will capture all incoming events and formulate JSON body, which all properties available in the message context. Then we will push that event to the BAM. So in the BAM side, we will do some summary generation. Then we will write them to the summarized tables. Then later we can use them to do our own analysis. So when we have this kind of data, we can easily check at which time we will get more requests, at which time users will place more and more orders. So likewise, we can easily identify in weekdays morning time users will place more breakfast sandwich orders, and also during the weekends users will order family packages, and also we can get some idea about what is the most selling sandwich type, and also we can get a rough idea about time to process sandwich request. So likewise, we can get different information from them. Then again, based on this information, we can properly plan our business. So when we collect the stats and when we analyze them, we know what we need to do next. So like I mentioned early, if we see certain area of the country doing more and more requests and they do more and more purchases, then we can place we can start new shop there and let the business grow. So likewise, we can easily use this stats and expand our business. Now let's discuss about how we can integrate our business with different external services using APIs. So if we consider this sandwich factory example, when users buy sandwich, they have to pay for that sandwich. So if we integrate this with the external systems like PayPal, MasterCard, Visa, Google Checkout, so if we can integrate with this kind of payment processes, then users can easily pay for their sandwich using any of these system. So to do that, we need to use their APIs. So what we need to do is we can integrate our solution with the external systems through the APIs. So in that case, we need to use their APIs. So with that, customer can place their order. Then they will directly go to the payment process. So once the payment process done, they will send response back to our application. Then we know this particular client has done all the payments. Then we can proceed with the sandwich process order, and they can buy the sandwich. And next thing is loyalty and rewarding programs. So if you have used this online buying and checking application, so you have seen that once you do some purchase, you will get a certain amount of reward, or you will get some discount and those kind of things. So these things again done using the external system API. So when someone buy sandwich from our system, we can add some reward to them by calling to external system. So those events will be captured at external system, and when they try to buy something in the next time, we can call external system and get customer's history. And based on the history, we can reward them for their new purchase. So likewise, we can apply this loyalty and reward program to our sandwich use case. In this case, again, we have to use external APIs. Next thing is sharing this experience with the social media. So let's say someone get the sandwich from our sandwich factory, and they found it very good, and they need to tell it to others. So in that case, they can call to Twitter or Facebook or Google or any other API and post about their experience. So with that, all other around world will get some idea about this service. And again, for this, we need APIs. So with this API, users can share their experience with all their friends and other people that they engage with the social media. And also, some cases, we may need to track our orders. So when you buy something from Amazon or eBay, then again, you will get the tracking ID. So when you have tracking ID, if you want to check where is your package now, then again you need to call to different external services and pass this tracking ID and check where is your package. So if you apply this to our sandwich factory sample, once user place sandwich order, we will process the sandwich and we will handle sandwich to the external part to deliver it to the home. So in the meantime, if client want to check where is my sandwich, then they can call to external traveler company APIs with the tracking ID and check where is my sandwich now, so something like that. So that is another thing that we can do with the external APIs. And with that, I will hand over session to the Danuka. So from this point, he will continue the session and he will do the demo part as well.
Yeah, so guys, integration with different sensors. So let's say now, from our sales application, we need to share the transaction portion for other merchants. So we can do that on demand using our API services. So that's a really good advantage when you are doing online transaction. So that's a key feature of merchant collaboration. So when we are talking about these kind of features, we have to face some kind of integration challenges, like some third party services support XML, some of them support JSON. So we need to do some transformation. So if you're using API manager like WSO API manager, that can be done inside the API manager seamlessly. So also some services support SOAP, some services support REST services. So that also can be done seamlessly without doing any coding. So also, if we talk about business intelligence, so business intelligence is a key factor of competing with others. So you need to have a proper insight about your business, who's playing a key role in sales, and who's playing key role in merchandising. So these kind of insight can be gained if you integrate WSO2 Dash or WSO2 BAM with API Manager. I think Sanjeev also explained about statistic, API Manager statistic and Dash in the earlier slide. So now I will go to a demo that in this demo I'll show you that how we call SOAP based backend using a RESTful API. So please bear with us. We need some time to set up this. So I'll take few minutes.
API. So API name is API 1. So this is the API URL. So if I go to SOAP, this is the SOAP backend service. So we call SOAP backend service with SOAP pen develop. We're getting this response. So what we're going to do is we'll call our API, the REST API, using REST client, and we are sending that same SOAP request as a payload, and we are trying to call SOAP backend service through WSO2 API manager. So the important thing is from REST to SOAP transformation done inside the WSO2 API manager. So we don't have to do anything. That transformation handled by WSO2 API manager. So this is the URL that I showed earlier in the store location. So this is actually WSO2 store. So this is the API URL. So I'm using the same one. So this is the authorization, and we need to mention So section. So once we call that API, we are getting the same response. If we go to SOAP UI, if we directly call the SOAP endpoint, we are getting the same response. So this is about how we can use WSO2 API manager for a particular scenario.
I think we can conclude this webinar today. So thank you very much everyone who joined. Thank you very much, and we will see you again in the last session of this webinar series. Thank you.
Thank you, guys.